Hi and welcome to the very first actual Fuseday video. Today I'll be showing to you and sharing with you a new macro that I have been developing. It's called SDR Visual Crop and it's a visual way to crop your images inside of Fusion and Resolve, of course. But before I do, hit like, subscribe and the bell icon to receive notifications whenever a new Fuseday video is released. Now let's get on with the macro. I have used the crop tool in Fusion for years and well, it's fine. No, it's not. Well, it works, but intuitive, it's not. As soon as you've started cropping, you can no longer see what part of the image you're missing. Also, it's always a bit of a hassle to keep your subject in the frame. You always have to reposition, so you keep jumping from slider to slider again and again without having a visual reference of what it is that you're doing. On the Blackmagic Design Forum, there have been lots of requests to make Fusion's crop similar to the one in the Inspector of the Edit page. Just four sliders and, if you turn on the crop markers in the overlay, also a visual way to set up that crop. So that's what my new macro, SDR Visual Crop, is for. With this tool, it's possible to set the area you're cropping with easy on-screen controls. You can use the crosshairs in the viewport or the screw controls to define the area that you want to crop. Depending on your preference, you can do this while viewing the original image or the result. If you're doing very detailed work and the viewport controls are obscuring the edge of your crop, you can switch the view controls on or off. By default, the position of the cropped area is retained, as well as the original resolution, which can be useful for setting up quick and dirty split screen effects. But if you need the cropped area to be a self-contained piece of footage, you can press the Auto Crop button, which will only leave the cropped area that can then be merged over other footage. There are also sliders to affect the softness of the edges and the roundness of the corners. All values can be animated, of course, so you can also use SDR Visual Crop to create motion graphic elements, like growing lines for lower third animations or, well, whatever you feel like. So there you have it, SDR Visual Crop. It works in Fusion standalone and as an effect right on the edit page of Resolve if you install it there. It will also work from the Fusion page inside of Resolve, but it has a small glitch that I haven't been able to fix yet. If you add the tool to your comp, you need to press the Reset Size and Offset button once to make the macro adjust itself to the resolution of the media in that you're trying to crop. At the moment of filming this video, this tool is still on the waiting list to be added to Reactor, but as soon as it is accepted, you can install it from there. For now, you can download this macro directly from the thread over at stakeunderwater.com. I'll link to that in the description. For those using Resolve, I've also prepared a DRFX file if you want to use this macro inside of Resolve. You can download this from my Ko-fi page, and that link is also in the description. If you find this tool of value to you, you can buy me a cup of tea to show your appreciation. So that's it for me for today. I hope this video was useful and I'll gladly see you all next Fuseday. Let's keep that fuse burning.